on worldtabletennis.com. Let us know what you think. Nisha Lien starting it off. By the way, if you're newer to table tennis, that line in the middle of the table only means anything in doubles. The serve must go cross court as it is here.
Love two.
And another reminder, Luca's red side of the racket is frictionless, completely frictionless. So it's going to be very jarring to play against.
Yeah, Satyen is the only amongst the four who has the inverted rubber on both sides.
Three.
But good use of that inverted rubber there. Handles the spin coming in, just guides it back. He's going to be testing the footwork of Nisha Lien. Don't get me wrong, she stays close to the table for a reason, though.
Yeah, but all due respect for her, 59 years old, five-time Olympian, won the World Championship bronze medal in Houston in the women's doubles.
Left. Three.
In our lifetime, if we see anyone doing the things that Nisha Lien does besides her, that would just be mind-blowing.
Four.
Again, for table tennis fans that watch, say, the German League, where Luka Mladenovic is playing, it might be tough to understand until you've played against it. And people might say, oh, it's such a huge advantage to use this rubber. But can you talk to us about why that's not exactly the case?
Yeah, because to be using this rubber itself, the rubber produces so many different variations, like there from Nisha. Right, the ball goes short on the court, longer, far away from the table. The rubber itself produces so much spin. So you need to understand yourself, the rubber, really well.
Yeah, simply put, if it were such a big advantage, why isn't everybody doing it? I think playing with anti-spin is incredibly challenging. Nisha Lien, long pips on the backhand side, short pips on the forehand. She'll twiddle the racket sometimes.
Five, all.
And the twiddle is where they turn the racket 180 degrees. Can you tell us why someone would do that?
Well, to just give a surprise to your opponent, because when you have long pimples on the back, you give one ball with the long pimples, and second, you twiddle and punch it harder. The opponent is completely left surprised. I did that a lot when I was playing, and Manika, I would say, does it fantastically well on the tour, amongst the best in the world, I would say.
Good power there, a shot that might not get quite the attention that it deserves. Monica Batra's forehand attack.
And on Monica Batra's forehand, you know, interestingly, until she was a junior, her forehand was actually one of the weakest hands and strokes for her. Her coach made a lot of effort to bring that into her game. And now you can see how well she can do it. Nice one from Satyen there.
Yeah, he was quite patient, very clear on what was coming in. It's not easy, again, whenever it comes off that backhand from Luca's racket, it's like something you've probably never had the chance to practice against.
Seven, all.
It's really a devastating combination. Luca, the taller on screen there, the headband, his forehand attack, very strong. His backhand, not only does it reverse the spin of the ball, but it slows it way down.
Seven, eight.
And it's also harder for Manika to take on long pimples as an opponent. Because the ball does not have enough spin in it. Long pimples work very well when the ball is spinny. But when the ball is having less spin, it's harder for the player with the long pimples to give it back.
I like that. Luca turning the racket around to play a backhand attack with this inverted spinny rubber. That's Luca's leg there, not Nisha Lien's.
That was a very unusual tattoo.
That's how I knew it wasn't Nisha Lien's. Her tattoos are all pretty standard.
Yes, sir. 8-10.
So two game points here for the Luxembourgers. Still quite recoverable, though, for the Indian pair. What a recovery. The reach, wingspan, there is no shortage of on Monica Batra's side, but Nishalien really sent that ball as wide as can be. What a beautiful save there. And the ante comes in and takes it. So here we are, game number two, down 0-1, the Indian pair. Beautiful backhand rip from Satyen on the third ball.
Well, this combination could work well for the Indians because Satyen is generally very smart and good against long pimples. There you go. He's going to receive all the ones from Nishalien.
Yeah, you've got two different lengths from Nishalien. Nice save here from Ladenovic on the run. But what you talked about, Satyen, I think, is known for many things. One, being fast, but two, being quite smart. Obviously well-educated. Ooh, edge of the table here. Maybe not obviously, but being an engineer, being someone who adjusts to so many spins, I think this setup will favor the Indian pair.
Yeah, I've known Satyen since the last over 15 years, and he's one of the smartest, I would say, table tennis players India has ever produced. His ability to read the spins is just so quick, very nice in strategizing as well, and I think he's a very good doubles partner also.
Look at the use of long pips aggressively. Not easy to do to control such a long shot, but that wide forehand corner against Nishalien. She goes there once again. Can you talk to us a little bit about the tactics of going wide to the forehand of Nishalien?
Well, that's a no-brainer, right? Because the wide on a left-hander side will allow her, or sort of rather force her to make that step, which is slightly harder for her given Luka is taller, so they have less space between them.
Oh, also Luka wasn't born in the same year as Nishalien. Back edge of the table here for Satyen. And also, we didn't talk about this, a left-handed, right-handed combination in doubles is very preferred, I'd say. It's an advantage because you don't get in each other's space too much, and you have time in doubles, you're alternating shots, to play the big forehands and cover the middle. So from a footwork standpoint, the Luxembourg pair would have the advantage, but as mentioned, Nishalien at 59 years old is not going to be able to cover quite the same ground.
And also because she has to stay closer to the table to be effective. And it's hard to stay closer in more than 3 to 4 balls in when you're playing doubles.
Right. Remember, they have to alternate shots in doubles, unlike tennis.
Oh my goodness.
That right there should paint such a clear picture of how crazy challenging it is when you spin the ball into ante. Watch how much backspin comes back.
Yeah, and Monica's reaction was that she knew there's a lot of backspin, but well.
Look at her face. It went under the net. It went under the net. Not the top, not the middle of the net, under it. But not twice. She makes her adjustments here.
It's funny that now Monica knows what her opponent feels because her opponent now has the long pips.
Well, I hope he washed the spoon because she just got a taste of her own medicine big time out here.
6-8.
I think this point is going to be so crucial in this match. The Indians were leading 7-2, I believe.
I believe you.
6-9.
So making it count here. Just 3 points in front. There's a ball in play. Ball kid with some good footwork there. Wow. You couldn't even see it, like a ninja. Aya, indeed. Nishalien with a good opportunity near the net. If you don't speak Chinese, Aya is essentially like a oops. Oh no. 4 game points for the Indian pair. Quite an extended rally for the amount of funky shots that came on. Luka behind the table, Nishalien changing up the rotation as well.
I'm sure Satyen wouldn't have been too unhappy with that because that was a lot of backspin.
Nisha Lien doing what she does, takes it right off the bounce, sends it knuckling back to the baseline of the table. Two game points saved for the Luxembourgers. Coach S. Rahman. Jinx. No, I'm kidding. You can speak.
Now he's national champion and Olympian himself. So really nice to see former players coming in and coaching and becoming national coaches.
And a little break off the top of the net, but work well done.
Level.
Back for game three, Nisha Lien drying off the ball, getting ready to serve to set up Luka. Short side of the table, Luka on the move, all attack in this point. Did you catch what he said, S. Rahman?
Nice.
That was in Tamil, so I don't speak and understand that language.
That's one of many things we have in common, Neha. I also don't speak Tamil, despite being born and raised in Tamil Nadu.
That was a joke.
We'll let them decide that for themselves. Monica Batra and Satyanyana Shakaran up 2-1 to start this off. The pattern that didn't work out in their favor. So I had a chance to try Luka's racket the other day, and it's really fascinating. But the black side of his racket, as you've seen a few times now, he can use very standardly and aggressively. Perfect length on this one, a second bounce on the table. Neha, your face, talk to us.
Well, I tell you, the times Manika has been able to produce this, this is the best shot she ever does it, right? Somebody's hitting a hard spin on your backhand and she can make a shot block near to the net. How incredible is that?
Well, incredible enough that if you're the coach on the other side like Tommy there, you got a lot of thinking to do.
Yeah, you go crazy, right? How do you stop the ball so close to the net?
It's one of the most frustrating things. Again, much like the anti-spin, with no sponge, the ball slows way down, and here again, right near the back edge of the table. That's an incredibly uncomfortable ball to have to play.
Yeah, and you use a lot of your core strength and absorbing the speed of the ball really well.
Three, five.
I can feel the frustration here. Nisha Lien taking her chances in the receive game. But I think a big part of that is Luka hasn't been left with much to do after Monica's dropped these balls very shallow. Most unconventional rally in modern history. Every single shot in that rally was completely different. Fast and flat there, block Nisha Lien with the short pips flat hit wide and not even touched, not with the wingspan of Monica Batra, one of the two tallest in the women's game. But on the move, Sathyan quick and finding that angle. It looked like maybe that would have been surprising. Luka playing it on the parallel, but Sathyan had the racket up high. It's a big part of his game, too.
That was a beautiful one from Manika. The ball was, again, not coming to outside the table. She went in and managed to hit forehand down the line.
Nice parallel, Nisha Lien on the move. That wide forehand, I know you said obviously you're a no-brainer, but for a lot of people watching aren't competing in table tennis regularly. This one is not right at the line. It's baseline, but not so wide. Nisha Lien is quick to get there. Good knuckling shot there. Monica Batra sending it a little bit deeper. Again, the rotation off these long pips with no sponge. Even if Luka used the exact same setup, he's not playing against it often.
Yeah, Monica has been fantastic in this game so far. Remember, this is the same combination they lost the first game. And there were many more errors from her side in the first game. So she's really upped herself in this one.
Nine, six.
Good flick here from the back of the table. Nisha Lien putting some pressure on. A familiar score line like we saw in last game.
7.
And again, the flick here. Impressive speed and placement from Nisha Lien. Two-point game now. The Luxembourgers with the serves back on their side. Monica Batra on the receive of Nisha Lien's serve. The solid opening forehand, but Luka's right there for the counter. And we got a timeout. One-point game. And the forehand came out. They could not avoid Luka's strong forehand. I was serious, by the way. I saw you laugh when I said happy to have you here, but I wouldn't have understood that. So there you go.
Thanks, Adam. But look at how disruptive this rally was in terms of the number of spins and the different changes in the length of the ball. It's fascinating. I just love this style of play.
Same here. Tied up now. And four in a row sets up a game point for the Luxembourgers. They were down 6-9 and now have a game point. Remember, Monica Batra with a spinny rubber on the forehand, or at least let's say the black side of the racket. She'll twiddle and turn. Even on the serve, keep your eyes on it. Game point for the pair in blue.
10.
Good opportunity here for Nisha Lien, but a well-controlled shot. Monica Batra and Suthian survive. Not over yet. They'll alternate serves now until one pair has a two-point lead. Luka will almost never serve with the ante. He's going to play spin. And he had the forehand opportunity, a big surviving moment here to set up game point for the Indian pair and the pattern that has, well, been the better pattern for them.
And surely Monica has been the survivor here for the Indians.
Sorry, just to clarify, the better pattern actually for the Luxembourger pair. Game number one, the two on screen took the first game, but they're down game point now.
11.
A nasty shot that side spin. What are you thinking, Neha?
It's really hard. It was so low to the net, and Suthian attempted to step around and play a four, and he was not enough in time. The ball was very low.
That red side of the racket from Luka Mladenovic. The ball barely moves. It is so slow. And he played it with the ante on the forehand, and Suthian with the answer there sets up yet another game point for that 2-1 lead that the Indians are looking for in this best of five first round battle. Forehand does it.
This is what Suthian had asked Monica to not do, avoid Luka's forehand side. But well, in a rally that goes long, it's hard to control where you're deciding to play.
Yeah, I was watching. Luka was starting to step around the backhand corner, expecting it there. He also knows how effective his forehand can be. The surprise factor on his ante isn't quite what it used to be. As fast as can be on the 13. Parallel, Nisha Lien sends a knuckling ball to that backhand corner.
Yeah, look at how quick she was in that, just gliding the way through the ball and onto the extreme backhand side of Monica. She was not ready. She was probably expecting it on the forehand.
Surprise factor high, and now game points for Nisha Lien and Luka.
13.
Good pressure. Nisha Lien playing a little bit more passively there, the control game. Her body language said she wished she had countered it, but I think it would have been an even tougher shot. Excellent pressure from Suthian to save a game point once again. And the ante comes out,
14.
The backhand, the red side from Luka, slowing the ball way down. Much like when Monica doesn't have much spin to work with, Luka having to do a lot of work there to create an effective shot off of the long pips of Monica Batra. Game point for Nisha Lien and Luka.
That's a brilliant strategy. Right? This is something they've always done on crucial points. Manika with the short serve, allowing and giving Satyen for that heavy cross-court attack.
You can see the frustration on Luka's face. I think he knew as soon as he played it with the ante, he had already committed. He wasn't in a good position to get aggressive. Had he had the black rubber out there, he would have attacked that.
14,
well, this is hard. This is hard. It's a flick from the long pimples. It floats. The ball does not have enough spin. Again, like I said, it's hard for Manika with the long pips to give it back.
Did she just do that with 14. The long pips?
They could probably qualify. Be there.
A straight up chop from behind the table from Luka there. This fight will be fascinating as the match has been so far, but it's now or never for the Indian pair. It is must win game number 4 and game number 5 to move on. And a gift, a souvenir, no miyage.
Yeah, and in table tennis game, best of 5, 11 points, this can cost a lot.
Definitely taking her chances on serves. The combination for Luka to play that ball so fast off the ante and following up Ni Xialian. That's such a difficult ball to deal with. Manika has very little spin to work with on the forehand.
One, three.
So a good start here for Ni Xialian and Luka Mladenovic. Forehand to forehand, Satyen securing the point in a much needed point moment.
Well, the Indians are ranked 5th in the world and are up against number 127th in the world, the pair from Luxembourg. And if they manage to win, it's going to be one of the biggest upsets of at least the day so far here at the World Championships.
Right. Reminder, we've got 8 tables in action. You're watching the best one. Ni Xialian watching the spin of the ball, as you should be as well. There's just so much going on. Every single shot, no player out here has the same setup as the other. Not even close. I'd say the closest are actually the two tallest players on court. Luka Mladenovic right there and Manika Batra, both with an attacking standard rubber on their black side. And a very slow defensive rubber on their backhand or their red side, but they will twiddle, they will turn the rackets just to keep it confusing for the opponents.
Although I've not seen the twiddle from Manika enough in this match so far. And that's also because there's hardly time to do that. There's so much spin coming in from their opponents. It's not easy.
Yeah, I think credit to the Luxembourgers for keeping it so unpredictable, not allowing Manika to have the opportunity to have such a clear plan executed. 4 points apiece, though, the Indian pair back. That rally is outstanding.
This will probably hold the title or the vote for the most spinniest, unpredictable, weirdly placed shots in the history of table tennis.
Print that and put it on a plaque of a trophy. It's going to wrap around the entire thing.
Oh my God, Satyen, beautiful. You know, he's absolutely brilliant in taking the balls when they hit the net court. I don't know how he does it, but he really attempts it and makes it back every time.
Well, this is part of that brain power and reaction time, recognizing what it is first and moving right away. But a long serve here to the baseline, the frustration from Satyen. He was starting to move in. It looked like he wanted a backhand over the table. Takes a step in, looks for the Chiquita, the banana flick, but it's right at the baseline. Smart play from the ever so experienced Ni Xialian.
Seven, five.
I wonder why they served long. I mean, it seemed like it was a well-thought strategy, but not really the best move when you have two attacking players from the forehand side.
Well, I can tell you why. Nisha Lien was maybe, let's say, expecting a banana flick opening receive like the point before. I mean, we saw how effective it could be. It was just a quick adjustment from Suthian. And Luca, without using an attack in this rally, manages to save from behind the table. Some head shaking out there. I thought maybe there was question about if a ball came down or touched an edge or something. Either way, all fair and square. Still Monica Batra and Suthian up in this game, a must-win game. For the second point in a row, we've seen Luca chop with the slow ball coming in rather than twiddle or take a big attack.
Yeah, and credit to Monica for doing a backhand flick on that chop. Rarely seen that so far in this match.
Well, she's taken some chances, definitely pulled out of her comfort zone in this match.
Yeah, and knowing her, she takes her risks. She takes those calculative risks.
Seven, eight.
And a risky shot here as well. Nisha Lien down the line. Score line keeping some tension here. And that replay, it looked like we just saw Luca serve with the ante, which is incredibly rare. It's also possible he twiddled so fast, I simply didn't notice. But a beautiful receive here. Monica confidently taking her chance to put the pressure on, and it's a two-point lead for the Indian pair. Not easy to do with very little sponge underneath. The reaction we saw from Nisha Lien, how surprising that speed was from Monica's backhand. And a rip of a backhand here as well. Suthian confidently sets up three game points to send this to the decider. And for me, what could be the match of the day on table one. Well, now, here we go. Seven. It is going to game number five. So Nisha Lien to start it off. Game number five, here we go.
That was a loop from the forehand, long pimples. How hard is that to even attempt?
She had the short, she turned back. She turned the black side back.
Yeah.
So the fact that she's been serving with the red side, I'm confused. Talk to me, Neha. Are you thinking maybe
yeah,
the rubbers are the opposite?
Yeah.
Short pips red side.
Yeah.
That would make a bit more sense.
That's a wonderful. Well, hitting a very hard, spinny, fast topspin on the long pimples is always a good option. But well, it is for Suthian to get those opportunities to be able to hit those shots enough.
So just to clarify, it seems, and this is why players check the rackets before. They have a close-up view of the equipment. Nisha Lien, to our understanding, it appears has the attacking rubber of the two on her red side, but she attacks with both. Although the black side, long pips, she'll play a bit more defensively more often because she can slow down the ball and send it back knuckling and wiggling. 1 point game here, the Indian pair still up. I should say up by one. Beautiful ball from Suthian. It was not easy coming in, but it took a precise, confident backhand.
Yeah, and this is the combination that does not favor them. So in this deciding game, they are leading now 4-2.
Just to be clear, what you're saying is, had the Luxembourger pair got to five first, there would still be a close battle. But right now, the Indian pair is playing against the odds and having the advantage despite the tougher setup and order of play.
Absolutely, Adam. Well summarized.
Thanks.
That was a deep backspin serve from Suthian.
So they will switch sides, and because it's a doubles battle here, mixed doubles more specifically, they'll switch order of play as well. And a timeout now, a little conversation. I've seen Dungle, I've seen Three Idiots. I love Amir Khan. Well, now the timeout has not worked out in the favor of the pair that called it. It's the Indian pair who continues the momentum. What a touch shot, as short as can be. Nisha Lien having to leave the ground behind for this ball.
Yeah, although it was a very nice serve from Luka, it was not so spinny, just long and flat. Superb receiving from Manika there.
7-3.
So 7-2 was just on screen. The type of scoreline where someone could relax, feel a little bit confident. The Indian pair is going to do everything to play every point as if it's 0-0. Two in a row here, the Wigglers. Remember, no timeouts left.
My heartbeat is really racing up. This is so intense, Adam.
It is definitely intense. I'm glad that neither of us are biased in this.
Very intelligent serve from Manika Batra. She twiddled. Finally, she twiddled. And what a surprise from her.
It's funny. It's good you pointed it out. If someone wasn't watching for a moment, by the sound of this shot, Nisha Lien goes very aggressively. There's the twiddle, serves with the long pips. Nisha Lien knows there's not going to be much rotation and says, a little bit of height, I can kill this ball. But it didn't work out that way. Manika Batra, the creativity paid off. Big point once again. Nice. 2 points exchanged on both sides. The Indian pair feeling the heat from 7-2 up. After Luka and Nisha Lien scored two in a row, but 12 of the last 16 for the Indian pair. The step around, the big forehand from Nisha Lien. It's a 4-point game here. The Indian pair just needs two more. And the Luxembourgers a long way to go, but a step in the right direction. Nisha Lien goes for the attack, and the Indian pair now with 5 match points to move on through to the round of 32, the world ranked number 5, in good form here after that long ball knuckling to the baseline.
6-10.
But the Luxembourgers hanging on, saving one match point. 4 more to go for Satyen and Manika.
And Coach S. Raman just said that the serve will be without any spin. And so it was, and he is right. The Indian